So when you meet with your architects and you talk about, oh, let's design the next generation processor, what are really the design constraints that you think are at the top of the list? So certainly power is going to be, you know, number one for sure.
Yeah, so energy efficiency is always the number one design constraint. I think very closely behind it, though, is programmability and range of applications. And again, Sports for Divergence is a good example of that. We want to have you know, both a control structure and a memory system that will run diverge codes well, because that'll give us a broader range of applications. And then we'll look at programmability, and it's not just being able to write the program and get it to function, but to get a large fraction of the absolute performance you can get out of the machine without undue effort. And a lot of this is removing performance surprises from the architecture, so that if you write the code in a very straightforward way, you'll actually get pretty good performance, and it won't be awful, and then you'll have to sit there trying to deeply understand some obscure fact of the memory system to figure out why you've fallen off a performance cliff.
And that's something that's changed really an enormous amount in the last 5 years. The cliffs for GPUs have historically been steeper than for CPUs, but they're getting much flatter as a result of the work you guys are doing.